In this section, we'll be taking a look at what we've done so far and how it looks in PyVision. Navigate to the desktop and click on the PyVision shortcut. Once this is loaded in your browser, use the menu tree on the left-hand side to navigate to the Vibration RUL folder. Once in the folder, double-click on the Vibrations RUL display. Now let's go through what we can see on this display. So in the top left, you can see a moving average event count and a linear regression event count, these that we set up in AF earlier. You also can see the bearing life expectancy prediction of 11 days. On the trend, you can see in blue the raw vibration values, and in purple, you can see the high limit, which is our expected end of life. Then in teal, you can see the moving average of the vibration values, which considerably smooths out the trend and gives us a better fit overall for our linear regression. Then, if you take a look in orange, you'll see how the bearing life expectancy changed over time. You'll notice that in the middle of the trend, the value for bearing life expectancy plateaus. This could be for two different reasons. If you remember back in our analytic, we required for a prediction to be written that the slope had to be greater than zero. If our slope is zero or less, we'll never actually reach the high value, and therefore we shouldn't be updating our prediction. In our analytic, we also required the R-squared to be greater than 0.4. This was so that we ensured a good fit and we're getting a good value out for bearing life expectancy. So in this plateau, when no new data was written, either or both of these conditions could have been true. I hope that seeing this on all one display gives you a better idea about how predictive maintenance could be applied and how you could use it to better maintain your assets.